Most reflections done in Photoshop over the last couple of decades are wrong. I'm going to show you exactly why, and I'm also going to show you this is an area where AI really shines. Let's jump in and have a look right now. Just get it out of the way. AI to me is just another tool that I use in combination with all the other tools in Photoshop. It has its job, it has its place where it works well, and then it has places where it doesn't work well or where it's just quicker to do things manually, or maybe you want to do things manually. But where a challenge could come is for something like this image. I want to create a puddle with a reflection. Now, the traditional way of doing this, you know, how we used to do these reflections, and we've all seen these. I've made these tutorials myself. You command J to copy the layer. I'm just going to do this fast because I don't want you to do this because this is the wrong way. And then we're going to go here, and then we're like, oh, we made a reflection. Okay, so let's talk about physics in the real world. When you look at reflections, right now you're seeing a little bit of the underside of this, but not a ton. When you are looking at a reflection here, you should not be looking at the same surfaces. You should be seeing a different angle. So what happens is when you make a reflection, you're looking at it from a different angle. So whenever we do these fake reflections, which I've done for decades and got away with, but if you want to make a real reflection, it should show a slightly different viewpoint. So this is where AI can come in use. And if I make a selection, let's just use the lasso tool. So we're going to make this shape here, and we want to make this a puddle. So if I go into generative fill and I say, now in the prompt, it's really important to tell it reflective because it will make a puddle of water, but it might not reflect. And then we're just going to let it go ahead and do this. And we'll see what we get. So sometimes I'm doing composites and I might use it. So here we go. So sometimes I'm doing composites and then I'll use generative AI for little touches like this. You know, if we look at the second variation or the third variation, you know, we'll look at it here. And notice what it's doing is it's showing the underside. See here? That underside of that vehicle is a correct reflection. But unless you're using generative AI, you would have to have a photograph of the underside of that vehicle that you could use to create a realistic looking reflection. So, you know, even if you want to minimize your AI use and you want to do compositing or photo illustration, sometimes AI can be useful for stuff like this that is just going to be more accurate than just doing it with Photoshop tricks. So hopefully this video has helped you to understand reflections a little bit better. Let me know in the comments underneath if this helps you. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you want to see how to change the color of something, check out this tutorial right there. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.